Hello everybody, I'm Cursedmonk and this will be a short series tutorial for Maya interface. Besides, if you have any questions regarding Maya, just go to my site, which will be www.ittau.com, and go to the forum section and try to find a topic which fits your needs, and that's it. Okay, so let's get it started. So I believe you have installed the Maya, and now just double click the Maya icon, launch a Maya, Now, then the Maya is running. First you need to understand what you are seeing. There's a lot of items displayed in Maya interface, and I believe that the best way to begin is learn the fundamental tools and then learn additional tools as you need them. Okay guys, so the first top line, it's menu bar, and menu bar is from the file till the assets, and after it goes a specific menu bar. The specific menu bar depending on drop down list here. For example, if I change from polygons to animation, check this out, the menu, specific menu, has been changed. And the second line is, it's a status line. So in the status bar we have a menu selector here. Here we have scene icons, selection mode icons, selection masking, snapping, rendering, and positioning. Here we have hiding icons. It's for attribute editor. This will be for tool settings, and that one for a layer editor. Okay, so third line is a shelf. Shelves holds shortcuts and icons, and more common tools that you might use in Maya. There's a shelf for each defined artwork, such as polygons, for example, or surface modeling. It's depending on which version of Maya software you are using, and it's simple to use. For example, if we want to add some shortcuts or scripts, we just need to go, for example, into a mesh or any other options, click Ctrl Shift and mouse left click, and here we have a combine icon. If you want to delete this icon or remove other icons, just click the middle mouse button and drag it to the recycle bin, and that's it. Of course, we can create custom tabs like that one. And if we want to create a custom tab, we should go to this triangle, press it, and on the new shelf, just press the left mouse click and enter the name. For example, I will pick the custom 2. So as you see, we created a custom 2 tab, and if we want to add more icons, shortcuts, or anything, you can just click Ctrl Shift and left mouse click. Simple as that. Almost in the same method, we can delete the shelf, this custom shelf too. Just mark this tab and go to that triangle and delete the shelf. Okay. As you see here, we have more options like load shelf. For example, if you have a custom shelf, save them and delete them. And we have here shelf editor. In the shelf editor, we can rename, for example, a cube in, for example, your language. Maybe it can be different. You can change the icon, tooltip. Of course, you can add a script for mail scripting or Python. You have here double click commands or pop up menu items. And I believe this is it for shelf section. Okay, so now we're going to my toolbox. My toolbox contains common tools as well as layout buttons for changing views and layouts. The first one is a selection tool, that one. As the name explains, it's while this option is selected, you can use mouse pointer to click over a particular object to select it. You can also click and drag over the numbers of objects to select them all together. Also, we have a lasso tool here. He is also used for selections in any way that you can draw as a free hand, for example, like that, as you see. When you're drawing around the borders, to select them, just like that. Paint selector tool, you can just paint on the shape which polygons you want to select it. As simple as that. And for the move, rotate and scale tools, which are below, this object this tools using for transforming objects in Maya. The soft modification tool is used to select the sub-objects, elements and modify them by moving, rotating or scaling in a way that the neighborhood sub-objects also get affected by this deformation, with the effect being an inverse or distance from the primary selected sub-object. This square below, it's your last used command in Maya. It's like a shortcut too. For example, if we want to see here the last command, we should do anything in the Maya. So I will press on the cube, and as you see here, a cube will appear. Okay, so this button, it's a single perspective view button, which lets you view the workspace as a single large view from a single perspective. Right, like right now. We have below button for four views can be used to view a workspace in four sections, which each section contains the three orthographic views. First one is the top, second is the front, and the third one is a side. And the last one is a perspective view. So the outliner button, it's allowing us to choose all objects into the scene and rename them to be more organized. Because if we create a cube, for example, as you see, all the cubes will be P cube 1. If I create another one cube, will be P cube 2, and sometimes it will be really messy if we starting creating a lot of cubes or different shapes, and all of them will be just P cube or P sphere and the number. It's really not specific. And as you see in the attribute editor, we have more options what we can do with the cubes. Or we can go to channel box and see the positions in the 3D dimensions. So if you want to rename it, just double click my name and write a new name for this cube. For example, cube first one. And that's it. So now I will delete these cubes because we don't need them. We have here hypershade. This is where you will be creating your materials for your models when you try to texturing them. For example, if I want to create any texture on the that cube. Besides, if you want to see any material, you must press the number 6. Of course, you can press number 5, but you will just have this simple material as a lamber. But if you want to create and add the texture, you must press number 6 to view the texture. So I can select the cube. After it, I can assign the shading group to selection, and if I want to double click it, if I want to change a color, for example, in this Lambert material, I can just go to the attribute editor and slide the color, or can pick the color from the menu list if you press this white button. So like that. Of course, we have here transparency and more other stuff, but right now I believe we don't need to go in deep in this section. Of course, in here we have much more items, as you see, but with this all items we will working a little bit later when we feel more comfortable with a Maya software. And few more tips: it's a timeline for animation, and here we have a command shell for example, if we have any script or if we want to create any script. So let's try to create any cube. As you see in here, when we're creating cube command, it all was written in here in the mel scripting. So we just can copy the script and add to the shell as I showed before. And I believe this is it for my first tutorial introduction to Maya. Thank you. And bye.